Start with a couple of numbers. 70% of all aging is voluntary, and you don't have to go there. It is rot, and it's not biologically mandated. Some stuff you're stuck with. Your skin's going to get goofy like mine. Your hair is going to be see-through. Your maximum heart rate goes down. Your libido tails off. Too bad. But 70% you don't have to have until the end, the very bitter end. Not bad. Here's the other one. 50% of all the serious illness and accidents that people have from the day you turn 40 till the day you die, you can skip altogether. With all the pain and misery and lost joy that goes with them, those are wild numbers, and they're absolutely true. If you want to tap into that stuff, there's some stuff you have to know. You have to know a little about the science. Give you a quick dose. We have inside our bodies this amazing signaling system. Billions of signals inside our bodies all day long. More than all the emails in the world, all the telephone calls, all the transmissions, TV, inside our bodies. Very sophisticated system, very subtle. But the messages are very simple. It's always one of two things: grow or atrophy. Grow or decay. When you're a kid, the default signal is to grow. So no matter what you do, every year you get a little stronger, more coordinated, more fun, more sexual. Hell of a guy. Nice going. And then, round 35, that tide that the default signal sets up, the tide turns slack. And then it turns against you when the default signal is to decay. And that sets up a tide of aging inside your body, which is not so hot. There are only three illustrations in the book. They're chart. They look like this. You start at 40 or 50, and every year you get a little slower, a little fatter, more pain rack, less amusing, more grumpy, until you go over the waterfall. It's awful damn sad, and I'm sorry to talk about it. However, do a few things that you'll learn about now, and you can square that curve. You can be about the same woman or man that you were at 40 or 50 until you're 80 or beyond, and then you go over the waterfall. In fact, most of us are in such god-awful shape that you can get be fundamentally younger, functionally younger in every important way for 4 or 5 or 6 years, then it levels off, and then the waterfall. We are hard at work on the waterfall problem. But alas, we are making no progress at all. So what this is all about, it's the quality of your life, and it can be radically better. All right, now you know how incredibly important this dreadful aerobic exercise is. Dreary notion, but it really is. But I heard it from Harry, my pal Harry. I resolved to do it 4 days a week for the rest of my life. And I'm a bit of a biker, so I decided I'd go to spin class. Anybody know about spin class? Whoa, good for you. I've never done it. I decided I'd go. So here I go. I am at the gym. I have signed up for a year at shocking cost and have gotten a spin class schedule. It is 6:30 in the morning and I am feeling very, very shy because I am very old. I am 40 pounds overweight and I do not look becoming in my biking costume. The instructor, an alarmingly pretty woman with a slight Euro accent, sees me looking helpless. She comes over to my bike and shows me what to do. The huge flywheel in front, the thing to tighten it up, make it harder, blah, blah, blah. I know I could break a leg. The room fills with beautiful creatures in their 20s and 30s. One or two old numeros, but no one vaguely as old as I am. The music starts, a din with a heavy, compulsive beat. The instructor has a mic, and she starts telling us,